Okay, again, sorry, here some movies are not playing. The basic idea here, we now try to leverage on our grid that basically connects many, many hospitals with many, many, many cases. If I have a new patient that comes into my hospital, maybe I haven't seen such a thing before. We are not dealing with the common cold. We have very complex diseases. So I can ask the system, okay, have there been similar patients? I can start trying to cluster the patients of all the hospitals to see, are there some subgroups that behave similar? And in the end, basically, based on where the current patient, it will be placed into one of these subgroups. I can say, okay, here is a group of patients where I could perform surgery and it was okay. So the surgery was a success. So this seems a likely course of action for me. This is the basic idea. So we have some validated cases in our database. We have a new case. We look up which cases are similar, and then we look at the outcome of these similar cases. Okay, so what are the advantages? This clearly is a method that relies heavily that we do have this grid, that we have a lot of validated high quality data at leading centers. It is very generic. The idea just compare to patient records is very generic. So actually we have done this with genetic data, we have done this with imaging data, compared imaging data, similar images, and also with clinical data. All you need basically is you have to define what is similar, what is your distance between two patients. And here we offer two possibilities. Either the clinician tells us, okay, for me ejection fraction is the most important thing, show me similar patients with regards to ejection fraction. Or we can say, no, the system can learn something. So if we have validated data, we just give the validated data to the system and the system does the clustering, the classification for us. So we have both approaches. We can visualize this in graphs, as you have seen before. And basically, there's two main clinical use cases for such a system. One is the support in diagnosis. So have similar patients been diagnosed as diseased or have they been healthy? Which kind of subtype of a disease? And treatment selection. So did similar patients profit from treatment? Could it be some surgery, for example, or some chemotherapy?